is for you, sun, moon, rising, or Capricorn energy, or anyone that hears it, whenever. It is for the time of September, August, 2020. Whenever or whoever hears it, I ask that you come in the name of the most benevolent love upon high and in the name of compassion for the greater good of all beings. That's a safe one. All being greater good. Everything's good. How does that work, you say? How can everything be good for everyone all at once? Not possible. Well, okay. You're going to try to tell me you know how the universe works? Like, the ins and outs, really? Seems like whatever we can imagine comes to be. So, why can't we imagine a world where everything can work in a way of harmony? Isn't that what nature does? Now, we might perceive it to be a conflict, but whose eyes are we looking through? I'm not God. I can't see through God's eyes other than my own eyes. Therefore, I say for the greater good of all beings, because God knows better than I do. Now, if you don't believe in God, that's fine. You know, whatever you want to call it. I know that you don't think that you're the omnipresent being of all. And if you do, I guess, you know, if you don't believe in the spiritual stuff, you wouldn't be watching us. So do I need to keep going? No. Capricorn, oh my God, you know that. I know that. I really hope and pray and feel that Capricorn is coming out of, shall I say, a rut or a shift or a sham or a vice. Coming down off Capitol Hill? What does that mean? That's in my head. I don't know what that means. I think it's because I'm looking at this building. It looks like the White House. And who's these people here on my fabric? This is fabric. It's a tapestry. These are my mother's. Yeah, I'm so nervous. Beautiful tapestry. So anyway, Capricorn, let's get into it. Oh, yeah, we've been through some shiz, and it has been hard, and now we're at a point where we need to make a decision. Actually being in that state of indecision that the Two of Swords represents. That stance she has holding those swords. You'd think your arms would get tired after a minute, right? Well, sometimes you gotta stay there for a minute. You need to know how to stay still so you can feel the air change to know it could be that subtle. You see her feet here. Are yellow, touching the ground. The ocean is behind her, the psychic energy. She has the swords in the air to feel the change in the air, the change in the tides. The moon is pulling the tides. The moon is connected to her feet. Her feet are connected to the earth. The earth is her stability. She has to stay there. Or they, or he. Okay, of course. Right? Until what? Until what, Capricorn? I see here that there's been lack of work, lack of access to work, lack of employment, unemployment, loss of work, laziness, procrastination, inhibition, inability, skilllessness, skillful procrastination. The unwillingness to do one thing at a time, the relentless desire to have it all but not willing to take the steps. The inability to keep things straight. No motivation. Depression. ADD. Capricorn. Top that with the magician reverse, and it's like, yo, what the heck have we been through? I say we because I'm a Capricorn too, so I mean, we all have our different stories, right? There was some crazy stuff going on in the last 5 years, for sure, for everyone. A Capricorn, you know, Saturn was in our house, then Pluto was already there, so you know it's been hard on you your whole life. Then Saturn comes home, and Daddy's home, and we get just floored, and it's pedal to the metal, baby. Some people good, some people not so good. Some things that went bad turned out good. Some things that went good turned out bad. It went everywhere haywire, and the only thing that we could do was persevere and say goodbye. And survive and step forward and climb up and move and bend the knees. You can't climb a mountain without knees. Every time you take a step, Capricorn, forward, you bend your knee to step up. If you can't, imagine trying to walk up a steep hill in stilts. And I'm not talking about in a spiral and on a low gradient. I'm talking straight up. It's not possible. You're right. Unless you did it backwards. The stilts on your hands. But goats don't go backward. They very seldomly go backward. You understand? Very rare. And if they are going backward, it might be because they're about to charge. It's kind of the only time we go back. Now, maybe you've been in a retreat. Honey, I know I've been. Maybe you've been in a retreat. But some of this isn't good. I think that we as Capricorns, and I'm not the only one who thinks that, but I have been knowing this, okay? So I know other people say this, but I've been knowing this my whole life. Hold on. Got a friend coming over. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, come in, Daddy. How are you?
I'm pretty good.
Ooh, love your hair.
Thank you.
That's so cool looking.
Thanks.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, of course.
Have you tried to braid it yet?
I have not. I'm sure it'll be nice. She's in her room.
Okay. You need anything?
I'm good, thank you.
Okay. I'm recording a tarot reading, so.
I'll be.
Just say, yeah, it's fine. I can edit stuff out, so. But. Okay. Cappy. I have teeny boppers, and I love them. Love my teens. They're cool. I love being around them because they remind me that there's still passion in life because they're very full of life, you know. And it's important for us to be good role models to these kids as best we can. And it's important for us to respect them, you know. Respect them, respect their truth, and respect their boundaries. So, anyway. Also, I'm trying to bring joy into their life. So anyway, we create a safe space. Mm-hmm. Always create a safe space wherever you go, Capricorn. We always do. We are that space. Unless we're haywire, then we are the devil. It's not good. It's like the devil has two sides too. all things that are do. So, you know, the good side of the double is safe space, boundaries. The all-seeing eye can see what's going on, you know, what's sneaking up on you. You can't be totally naive, but you must not become the evil eye and project the filth of the earth onto the world around you. And that's the thing about Capricorn, huh? So, the Magician reverse is less than savory. I see that. You can't walk up a hill in tall stilts straight up a hill. You can't. You gotta bend your knees. You got to have knees, and that's where Capricorn rules. We are that part of you. When it's time to work, when it's time to climb, when it's time to say, everybody, it's time to be quiet, stop arguing, stop all your hooting and hollering, and just round them up, move them out. And I think that that's part of the lesson for you here. Look, you might have felt like there was a lot of weight on your shoulders, because there is. I'm not gonna lie. It's kept you in a place of holding. This is when you went silent, Capricorn. This is a little bit more recent. You had to heal this stuff, and you know it. This is, oh, I know what I was gonna say, Cap. I believe that Capricorn, according to astrology right now, has had a major shift, not in a shift like Leo shifts, like overnight. No. Major shift that took centuries, if that more. Okay? Where we have been facing a kind of, well, karmic reconciliation, a reprint, it hasn't been easy, because some of it was our karma from past lives that had to be dredged up. Kind of in a super speed, because we were also moving very heavy lineage, sludge, Luna sludge. Now, that has been changing. And you, I believe, if you're like me, are normally the Knight of Pentacles right side up, where we see the hill and we don't go, oh God, no, never mind, the hill's too big, it's not worth it, guys, come on, let's go run. No. We see a hill, and if it's, that's the efficient way to go, maybe not easier, but efficient. We don't see it as an obstacle. We just see it as a hill. We just say, okay, let's go. Let's go. Clomp, 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 clomp. One step at a time. Are we in a hurry? Maybe not. There's always a reason why. People don't always see why we do things. If they had any idea how much we are calculating, when we already have made the decisions we made. But that's when we are making decisions. That's when we are choosing, when we are aware, and we are making choices for ourselves, right? When we stop choosing and we stop climbing, that's bad news for everyone. Now, we went into a silent mode. There's a time of silence here. The limbo of thought a little bit of that big R word with, when it comes to the lack of communication going on from you. But there's something going on with you that can't really be put into words. You already know you got these things to deal with that are imbalances of desires and dreams. And you've really been doing a lot of research. Putting yourself to the test through school. And that's because you haven't actually given up. Even though everything else might tell you to, or other people might tell you to, or something might tell you to, or you've been telling yourself that it's better if you just give up, or I don't think it's gonna happen, because you're very logical, Capricorn. So you're gonna see the logic behind having hope. And you're gonna say, well, it's better just to have this type of faith in my life than not. Because if I do, I can create something. And if I don't, I'll just stay in limbo. And so this future, I think if you have Aquarius in your signs at all, it's easier for you to accept the future into your life than another Capricorn. Okay? And that's because the Aquarius is the air sign and it's outer space, and it is the future sign, and it is a sign of the future of our age that's coming. Not quite there yet. You see? There's a novice sense. There's a sense of not knowing. There's a sense of wanting to say something, or saying things that were irrational, or maybe someone younger. Capricorn, you got mixed up with something that was not right for you. I think we're coming into the present now, or the very recent past. Somebody was being irrational about their decisions. Somebody said yes too soon. Somebody forced their way in when they didn't have a place, and they got spit out the other side. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Isis was like, nah, dude. This intention was lack of intention. This was impulsive. This was carnage. This was ultimately destructive. And even if it wasn't, it still would have been premature. But then comes justice, the bottom of the deck. You aren't supposed to know everything, Capricorn. You're not. Yeah, you haven't been able to, wait, let me see this. You haven't been able to It's not fair. It's not fair wasn't seen, isn't recognized yet. It's coming to a balance. It's asking you to look at it like it's a new beginning. It's not going to hurt as bad as it has. And there is justice to some kind of deceit. There is justice, and it requires you to do work that only you can do. You're the one. You're the one. You're the one, and you know it. But something came along and went whoop whoop all up in the plan. Don't let it knock you off. You gotta knock it off. You gotta knock it off, start over. You can never go back, but you have to start thinking differently about it, because that's why you're here. That's why you're here, and you have to start over. Okay? It's okay. The fool is a blessing. September, Libra season. There's a time when you do get balance from this, and it will be recognized. Okay? But it is hanging in the balance on whether or not you do the work alone. Because it's the deceit that you face by someone who misused their creative energy, their power, their sexuality, their actions. And it taught you something about illusion. It taught you something, Capricorn. It taught you something. And it actually is a portal. It's a portal, Cap. Look to the moon. Pay attention to the moon. It's not even important whether or not you won or you win. It is very important that you do it in the right time, or not at all. Choose. You've got to choose. The work you do is your own, but then it's your own victory. Then it's your own victory. The pettiness, the argument, the sideways comments, the lack of understanding, the misuse of people's sexuality, passion, dreams, ambition, the loss of opportunities because where you were supposed to be, you weren't there. Why? Because you were dealing with this person, or this argument, or that argument. This behavior, you gotta see this. I just opened the deck. This behavior has caused a lot of stress in your life, Capricorn. Hey, this isn't just about me. I know, like, you might think I'm projecting. I'm not. I'm reading the cards. And I've been doing really good lately, okay? So I don't think, for me personally, I'm gonna have a bunch of this kind of energy, Seven of Swords and Nine of Swords in my life in the next coming months.
I've gotten through this, and I want to, you to know I've been through it, and I'm doing great. So if you're going through this, this is something that has happened or is happening. I'm into if this is what's happening. This behavior of not being present, skipping away, skipping school, ditching out, flaking off, disappearing, same one thing, doing another. We're growing out of that? You growing out of that? Is it someone around you? Do you notice when someone leaves behind the choice for someone else to deal with because they didn't want to face the choice? But they're the ones that brought the whole thing in the first place. So they'll just take, they'll argue, but they'll leave you with the choice. They'll fight, but they won't take accountability. Leave you with the choice. And that kind of behavior is going to bring so much stress that you won't be able to sleep. Well, nightmares, or in my case, I want to wake up. Sometimes I feel everything run through my head right when I wake up. So we have to do things to feel better, Capricorn. So maybe you know this. Regardless, if you're really finding your ability to start over, and I'm happy for you, because that's what I'm saying, this ancestral lineage stuff we've all been healing. Have you made it through the portal yet? Have you made it? Because it's closing. And I'm not saying you're going to be doomed, but if you don't do the work, you're going to feel it. You're going to miss an opportunity. If you don't do the work, you're going to miss an opportunity. One that could change your life. One that could bring travel. One that could bring newness to your life. You understand? Yeah. If you don't start over and you keep doing what you've been doing, or think that you're going to repeat, you don't do the work on your own, you keep arguing this thing that's never, ever, ever going to be resolved, and deal with people who will bring you into more conflict, right? You go on, and you become something you don't want to see in a mirror. I don't know if I'm talking to you or someone in your life. Maybe this is the words you want to say to someone. Right? You know? Regardless, if you choose to change, then more things will come to your life. Right? Again. There's a lot of unhappiness here. So, Spirit, if this person chooses to start over, like the fool, do the work on their own, commit, what's going to happen? Okay. There's some things that are going to come at you, okay? Spirit wants to move on and tell you. So say it. Keep procrastinating or keep arguing with yourself. Say you don't get stuck in a negative loop. Say you move forward in this Aries energy using the new moon of Leo to learn this lesson about illusion. Say you forgive yourself for your silence. And you go here. Let all this other stuff go. Spirit wants to tell you something. Options are going to come into your life.
two people will come to you. One of them is Page of Pentacles reverse. The other is Page of Cups. You are going to be challenged. As you move forward, the first thing that's going to come to you is two different things, two different people, two different offers, two different directions. One is earth, one is water, one is earth, and you will be able to tell it's not practical, it doesn't make sense, it's wasteful, or it's not going to grow into something. The other thing that will come will be a little bit shy, a little bit quiet, a little bit off, a little bit sweet, a little bit coy. Capricorn, if you go into this next chapter in your life, the unsung kind of sweetheart might be the right way. But let's look into it. Okay? Alright. So, Spirit, this thing's shuffle. It's just a lot of chaos going on. This Capricorn has a choice to make between the Page of Pentacles reversed and the Page of Cups upright. Can we see what happens with the Page of Cups? There is going to be an argument. Maybe someone doesn't like it when you choose this, but it is a choice. At least you're walking away and you're leaving the decision now. You're not being in limbo. If you go with the Page of Pentacles, you get a really, really not so good thing. A misused relationship. A karmic relationship that is bringing you sadness. An imbalance. But it will bring forth it could be the ending of a relationship. Yeah, it's not going to bring you anything good. It will bring judgment to your life, but it will also bring the loss of a dream. So back to the Page of Cups. Because what's this five about? It's change. Might be you saying no more. I think that when you go into this subtle, sweet energy and you choose the Page of Cups, you have to kind of put your foot down with some people that you've been arguing with for a while and end it. It's conflictual. Isn't that funny? It's like conflictual for you to choose something that is obviously more emotionally balanced and not as chaotic. But there's also conflict with that. And so, what does Spirit have to say? There is somebody that you are cutting out, that you're going back to your innocence. You're not going to choose to continue to trust somebody who doesn't know how to value what's in their hands. You know it's going to lead to unhappiness, Capricorn. you trust this loving, sweet water energy, this Piscean energy, this Cancer energy, this sweet. It's not that it isn't mature. It's that it doesn't have to be everything all at once. It's a little different, and that's okay. I feel like curiosity, following this curiosity, can bring in conflict. But the conflict is with something or someone that is just awful to be around. Lazy, selfish, out of control, overly consumptuous, overly luxurious, latent, energy is like it's insulting. So you're done with being around this energy. You're like, bye, Lalisha. I know I said that wrong on purpose. It's you being like, you know, why are they holding themselves so low? So low that they are losing sight of their own God, of their own son, of their own worth, of their own body. This energy has got to go. It's gotta go. So you're fighting it. Remember, this is to start over. And this is a choice you have to make for yourself. Don't get caught up in what things seem. I feel like you learned this now with all that glitter and gold. But these cards sure are. When you do that, when you fight this, you fight for your future. You fight for your hope and your dreams. Because my friend, my dude, you are meant for greater things. You are meant for greater things. It's the star, baby. You're meant for greater things. This is a beautiful blessing. You see, it gets weird at first, but you're fighting off this energy. No more procrastinating. No more laziness, because as soon as you go into this subtle, sweet energy and you stop going towards this promise pie in the sky bullshit, comes back around to what you wanted in the first place. Okay, so you need to be careful about appreciating it. Okay. Capricorn. There's a story here, and it has to do with the Queen of Wands reverse. This person is sexually active in a way that is not very healthy. This person might have no problem with adultery. This person might have been or is destructive in their behavior. Not necessarily what they say, but what they do. Now, what does that mean? Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Well, she's still, you know, there's two things that she could be. She can be on fire. Still as very sexy as can be. But her ill will or ill intentions or lack ability to have control over her behavior causes a lot of fires burning that are not good. When it's the middle of summertime and you don't want a fire to start. Right? You don't want a fire to start. Because it'll turn into a forest fire. And people have to risk their lives to put it out. Just because of one spark that was thrown in the wrong direction. Somebody not paying attention to where their spark flies. Someone could get hurt. So who is this? In your life, Cappy. Whoever it is, it might be you. Let's just, it's okay if it is. Whoever it is. If you're a cross watcher, I don't know. I'm not trying to hurt anyone. But I'm not judging, but this person is not trustworthy when it comes to what they do. Not necessarily what they say. They might use their abilities for their own selfish needs, and that is not out of naivete. It is causing a very big imbalance. It's not fair. It's not right. She might have been abused. She might have been abused. Something. She might have been abusive to someone, Capricorn. She wants to run the show, but nobody should let her run the show. Capricorn, the way to deal with this is to take action in the right. Look at your life and evaluate now into where you are now and be unafraid of the new opportunities coming into your life, Capricorn. Stop telling yourself you can't do it. I think also there's a part of you that is afraid that you won't make it. You gotta bend your knees, baby. You gotta bend your knees and climb. You're going to see yourself in a situation where you got two things you're trying to juggle. And it's a little bit tumultuous, but you're doing it. And it will forever be a time of change in your life anyway. You are changing. You're not going to sit and wait for something to come to you anymore. I see that you are taking action in a new direction. And it's this abuse and injustice that's firing you up. And you want to protect what's yours. And you don't want to feel stressed about it anymore. And you aren't going to be the one that's stuck out by yourself or feel alone or alienated from the world. You're coming in and you're like, bish, no. You don't care anymore. Capricorn, oh my God. This is the third time. I keep putting this page of pentacles in reverse down and it keeps popping back up. I'm getting fired up. I want to see. We got to read this. Because, what the heck? Listen, you're moving forward. You're going to speak your truth. No one's going to stop you from saying what you're going to say. And it doesn't even matter to you how it looks. Be careful with yourself. Don't crash and burn. Remember to appreciate what you have. Don't sit and wait for for the offer to be perfect, go forward, change. What is this Page of Pentacles doing? Again, reversed. You see, this indecision, this nightmares, this fear of being alone, this death, this grief is being changed with the Ace of Wands, Capricorn. What is this Page of Pentacles reverse? I have to look at the book because I keep bringing it up and I keep saying it however I know how. And sometimes, you know, it could be a child involved, especially a Taurus or a Capricorn. Maybe there's a Taurus or a Capricorn or a Virgo, I guess, but more Taurus or Capricorn in your life that is immature about their body, their self-image, or what they put in their body. Or maybe they don't follow through with what they say they're going to do, or they're afraid of going out on their own, but they don't want to be told what to do either, okay? It could be a teenager. But let me look. Here we are. The Knave of Discs offers assistance. Okay, so we're going to look at this as the reverse. This is lack of loyalty. This is somebody who was not loyal. This is somebody who isn't actually worth trusting. Spirit, help me out here. It's just gotta change. You know what to do. It's time for you to be independent, to fill your niche, to fight for yourself, to look at things. To look at things differently. Do you see this? You know why I'm laughing? Look at this. Two different decks. You know, we already had the Page over here. We already had that, right? Two pages. We had two, Five of Swords. Do you see this? Do you see all these doubles? Do you need me to bring it back so you can remember? We gotta end this reading here. Oh shoot. Give me those. Where is it? No, it's in here. You know, anyway. You know we had doubles. There's so many doubles here. Okay. Just means that you have to see the wounded warrior. It's time to change. It's time to change. This person, this energy won't come with you. It's not loyal enough. Period. It's time for you to do your thing. Do you? Nine. Do you be? Do you boo? Bee bee boo boo. Come in with your truth and be like, look, that's the way it is. I'm fighting for myself. I'm taking a new opportunity in my life. I will not be ruled by this injustice. It's
sexual trauma. Capricorn, we gotta end this, but here, let's do a few more. You know. We don't really have to end it. It could go on forever if we wanted. Sometimes readings take a while. Let go of stress, baby, and laugh. That's some of the best advice. Whatever question you are asking, you see, when you let go of stress and you laugh and you let yourself feel you, not with anyone else's expectations of you, if you were to change tomorrow, and you let go of all the stress, and you just had a big laugh, and you just let go of all the stress, and you ask yourself, what do you ask yourself? Because in this, the answer says, yes, this card just came out. So whatever it is you're asking yourself, be yourself. Drink a lot of water. More water. Be like the water. Be yourself. Let go of stress. You got your brothers and your sisters. See the best in other people. Look to the best in them. Be like the water. Be yourself. Be yourself. Laugh. Let go of stress. Because the answer is yes. The spirit of mother and father are with you. Your cosmic parents, your parents, your ancestors are with you, Capricorn. Your brothers and sisters, there's a lot of family here. Just be you. Don't be what they want. Be you. Be you. Be you. You're not going to be abandoned. And if you have been abandoned, doesn't mean it's going to keep happening forever. You've got family around you. You have spiritual family. You have best friends. You see this? Don't let others talk you into doing something that you know is wrong. Don't. Imagine. Because what you want to see and feel and think and hear is everything to do with your lineage, your family's culture, your ability to heal it. So look into that. Look into what your family, your spiritual family, or your ancestors, your lineage, your spiritual lineage, your physical lineage, whatever. Anything that inspires you to learn about something that teaches you about who you are, to be yourself. Listen to your true feelings about it. Trust your instinct. You know, don't let any outside influence tell you what you're allowed to look into or what you're allowed to learn or study or be. Or any of that. We're all family and we all deserve a chance to be ourselves. We're all souls mixed up in this crazy world. So give it time to look at it, to really look at it. Eventually, you're going to see. I feel like you're letting go of a bunch of relationships. But you still have a lot of people that love you. You can't bring everyone with you on this. But it's going to bring in so much more than you realize. And you're going to be able to turn back. and look. And look. You're putting down a heavy burden. You're putting down a lot of weight that others put on you, and also your lack of doing. You have persevered. You've done so much. Count how much you've done. And don't forget that, because you are eradicating a self-destructive or destructive energy from your life, and you're releasing the swords from your heart. You're slipping out deceit, grief. Betrayal. Fear. Hatred. Shame. Devalue. Devaluement. It's all washing away in the rain. You're putting it down because you're done. And you get the Ten of Pentacles. And that brings in the blessings you're looking for. That when you do the work, you get to the Nine of Pentacles, then you are there, baby. Then you choose. Then you choose. Don't give up your choice until you get there. Choose when you are standing on your own two feet, when you know your niche is full, you got your thing going on, you do you, you be yourself. It has everything to do with your family and healing your lineage, looking at it from a new perspective, giving it time to stew, put it down, release the old karma. You will become much more independent, no longer afraid to change.